Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Okay, so when you are getting started with InDesign, you might also be getting started in design in general. So getting ideas for layouts can be quite tough. So inspiration is how you'll grow really quickly, is look at the best people around, see what they're doing. We're not copying here, we're getting inspired by, and we're appropriating their ideas and using our own content, our own fonts, our own colors. Yeah, so just inspiration. So the places to go, Pinterest is an easy one. It's the one in here in front of me. I put in magazine spread. Spread is two pages side by side and gives you an idea of, you know, just kind of ideas and might get started. You can, once you've signed in, you can start pinning them to your own boards and you'll have a kind of a collection of things you like. Okay, I like another version. It's very similar to Pinterest. It's called Nice. Okay, with two eyes. There it is there, .co. I like this one. It just, I find a better layout. So I've done the same thing. I've done a search for magazine spread. It just removes all the Pinterest kind of branding from it. I like this site. Just like Pinterest, you can have boards here. And when you get them all together, let's have a look at one of my boards, hand-drawn type. Okay. You can see here, you can start kind of gathering ideas to get your job going. Another really good one is Behance. Behance has some other perks other than just inspiration. I've done magazine spread in here. This is the place that we're gonna look at later in the tutorial for your portfolio. Okay, this is where people get found as designers more and more. Another perk in here is often they'll have, like, see this one here, it's not somebody's work so much as it's a photorealistic catalog magazine you can download and start using it, okay, like a little template. Now, one of the problems often is you'll see this and you'll say, great, here's a really cool cover, I really like it, but you have a different project. Somebody's come to you and said, hey, here's the cover, and they haven't said, here's like three words to put on it. They've said, hey, I want you to fill the cover with two pages of Word documents. And you're like, eh. You don't get to do lovely negative space and big blank areas because you've got to fill it jam-packed. I find the best inspiration for those kind of text-heavy annual reports, brochures, kind of really text-heavy stuff is to Google annual reports. So I'm in Google here, I've typed annual report, just add the word PDF. Publicly listed companies have to go and report their annual reports online, so you will find lots of stuff. And I've just clicked on a few of these and found, like, I don't even know what CRH is. I'm just kind of looking at how they're getting around, because you see, there's a lot of data they have to communicate. They've done some really cool infographics. Okay, they've gone for a three column layout, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so I'm just looking for it for inspiration, just thinking like, I never considered the big type down the side, big image. Okay, so getting ideas from this. Here's BMW's one. You can see somebody's gonna hand you a thing like this, and you're like, how am I going to show this Excel graph and actually make it legible? You can see here, they've done a really nice job of kind of clarifying the year that we're at. And yeah, you just work through some of these really text heavy documents and get an idea about how you might approach it. Another thing you can do is use a starter template. So InDesign especially, okay, if you go to New or File New, you go to Print, and let's say we're doing some sort of brochure or a magazine, you'll see underneath these blank documents now we have these templates. Okay, if you're using an older version of InDesign, it doesn't work. Okay, but here we've got some templates, and let's say we are doing some sort of, you can see there's a jacket, there's a food magazine layout. Let's click on this. And let's click on show preview, and it just gives you an idea. You're like, I like this, and you might start with this. And you can totally use this and just switch out the images. There's nothing stopping you. But what you'll find is you'll end up adjusting it to suit your tastes and your content, and it will change quite a bit, and you'll be able to kind of take ownership of the design. And all you do is click download. Okay, you've got to be connected to the net. It takes a little while, but eventually, the only difference is that these images won't be there when you open it. You can see now it's downloaded. Oh, there it is there, done. Click open. It's using fonts we don't currently have. We're gonna look at missing fonts a little bit later on, but we're just gonna click sync fonts and hit close. Okay, and you've got a magazine layout. The only trouble is without the images, it just doesn't look as pretty, does it? But hopefully you've got access to some images for your work. Okay, otherwise you're gonna have to go to stock library sites and start filling it in. It's a nice way to get started. Now, my parting advice for somebody who's a little stressed out for getting design ideas is that it does get easier. Nobody's born a good designer. But now you've got an interest and you've got some tools in this area, you'll start keeping an eye out for designs that you like, fonts that you like, colors you start liking. And what will happen after a few projects, you'll start knowing what clients like and what they don't like and what's worked and what hasn't. And as you get more experienced, you'll start to be able to pull designs out of thin air. But you're not pulling them out of thin air. You're pulling out of past experiences, successes, wins, losses. So that's going to be it for our inspiration section. We're going to go through onto the next section where we start updating somebody else's file. Very important.
So what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off, stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.